In this animation, you'll learn how to locate the center of gravity of regular and irregular objects, as well as how to calculate the net torque acting on an object. When you stand on one foot, your body automatically adjusts to find the center of gravity. That is, where the force of gravity appears to act. For symmetrical objects with a constant density, the center of gravity is bang in the middle, at the geometric center. For other objects, it isn't so easy to find. Consider a car. Manufacturers need to consider its center of gravity to make sure it'll be stable, especially during turns. But a car has many parts, from the engine to the wheels to the windscreen, some heavier than others. To find the center of gravity, consider the object as a system of particles. You need to find the average position of all the particles, weighted according to how heavy they are. In a constant gravitational field, center of gravity and center of mass are equal. Each particle has a mass, an x-coordinate and a y-coordinate. To find the x-coordinate of the object's center of mass, multiply the mass and x-coordinate of particle 1. Then add the product of mass and the x-coordinate of particle 2, the product of mass and the x-coordinate of particle 3, and so on. Divide all these by the sum of the mass of every particle. To locate the y-coordinate, use the same formula, but replace x with y. The sum of mass times y-coordinate of each particle divided by the sum of masses. Put the two coordinates together, and you have the position vector of the center of mass. If you suspended an object from its center of gravity, it would perfectly balance and could freely rotate in any direction. Torque is the rotational or twisting force that causes objects to spin around an axis. Say an object has an arbitrary shape. We can write the weight of each particle, vector wi, as the mass of that particle times the acceleration due to gravity, vector g. The torque acting on each particle is vector ri times wi. W, as we know, is equal to mg, so the torque on any given particle is equal to vector ri times mi times vector g. That's only for one particle. Torque for the entire object, represented by the Greek letter tau, equals the sum of torque for each particle. The sum of vector ri times mi times vector g. The equation for net torque can be modified and simplified to this, where m is the object's total mass. Sometimes there are no particles at an object's center of gravity. For example, a hoop's center of gravity is in the middle of the hole. Consider a uniform beam of length 15 meters and mass 10 kilograms aligned along the positive x-axis from the origin. A mass of 3 kilograms is placed at 5 meters from the beam's left end, and another 6 kilogram mass is placed at 8 meters from the left end. Determine the center of gravity of the entire system from the left end of the beam. We only need to consider the x-axis, since all the objects are in one plane. First, find the center of gravity of the beam alone. As the beam is of uniform mass, its center of gravity is at its geometric center. Now find the center of gravity of the entire system using the following expression. Inputting the values, we find the system's center of gravity at 7.3 meters from the left end. In this video, we've learned how to calculate regular and irregular objects' center of gravity and net torque. If you found this animation useful, subscribe for more.